In real-time companies, when we are working on a project, there are such a kind of situations where you have to give the access of your workspace where you have published your complete Power BI report to your team members or to your managers. So now the point is that how should we go and share our complete workspace to the team members in a team, in an organization? Hi, I am M. Asif Hussain from KnowHow Academy. What are we going to learn in this video? We are going to learn and understand how to share the workspace access to the manager in an organization. By the end of this video, you could be able to get a clear idea how to give the access of the workspace to the manager and what are the different kinds of roles do we have to give the access to the team members in an organization. So watch till the end. My dear viewers, here I have my Power BI report. So in this Power BI report, whenever I go to my Power BI service, and as soon as I open my Power BI service, we can see that. So here I have got my Power BI report in our Power BI service. Now the point is that in this Power BI service, as you have created this particular report and you have all the access of the data. What kind of data? The data that you have used in Power BI desktop in order to prepare a report. Now to prepare this report, you might have used data transformations, you might have done lot of analytical part, you might have done some interesting data understanding, you might have used the calculated measures, calculated columns, you have met the client's requirement, and at last you have prepared a report. So now what I'm going to tell it to you, here in the Power BI service, as you have done all these things in your Power BI report, so you are the owner of this particular report. So now in a technical terminology, if you would like to use the term, now we call it as an admin. So admin, who is an admin? An admin is a person who has all the access of a report. Now this admin can go and delete the data. Now this admin can go and modify the visuals. Now this admin can go and create a new workspace. Now this admin can go anything. Okay, so admin is nothing but the owner of the report. Okay, so now as you are the admin, now the point is that as you have prepared this particular Power BI report and which you have published in your Power BI service, now my dear viewers, you might have published this Power BI service by creating a workspace. All right, as we have discussed in our previous videos, what is a workspace? Workspace is a place in Power BI service where we go and publish the report. Now as per the report, we also get the schematic model or the data of that particular report into our Power BI service in the workspace that you have created. So the general example, if I would like to tell it to you, it is nothing but if you want to play a cricket, we need to have a playground. Now playground is very important in order to play the cricket. A plate is important in order to place some food on a plate. Am I right? So in the same way, a workspace is important in order to publish the report in your workspace. So now the point is that let us consider, now we have a team. Okay, we are working in a team. Now in this team, you need to give access to your colleague. Let's consider that your colleague is the same developer as you, but that guy might be good in cloud. Okay, so you have to give the access to him of your particular report. At the same time, we also have to give the access of your workspace, or you have to share your workspace with your manager. Now my dear viewers, think about it. When you would like to share your workspace where you have your report, where you have done your hard work and you have prepared a report published in your Power BI service, so now when your colleague is asking you to a particular report that you have prepared, it is your perspective. I mean, what are you thinking on it? Whether you would like to give the complete access to your colleague where he can or she can go and delete the data, update the model, not change the schematic model, change the visuals, change the data in it, change the complete structure of it, or whether you would like to just give the access to your colleague to just view the report in order to see what information I have kept in it. Or let us consider whether your teammate is equal to your contribution in the particular report. So whether he or she can go and change the visuals or select few visuals and copy that into another new page in order to do some small kind of interactions with your report. What kind of access are you going to give to your colleague? But now the point when I'm talking about the manager. So a manager, as he or she is the boss of the team, okay, so what we have to do, we have to give the complete access to them. So now what they can do, they can go and interact with the report, they can go and see what we have done in a report, they can see the visuals, they can see the data in the visuals, they could also see the schematic model what we have done, they can see the schemas that we have prepared, anything. So to do all these things, either that might be for a colleague or that might be for a manager. So how we have to share the workspace with these people? So let's watch here. So whenever I come here in a workspaces, there are multiple workspaces that I have it. So now what I'm going to do here, I have a three dots here where we have an option called workspace access. So when I click on a workspace access, we can see that this particular workspace that I am using it right now, there are two people who are accessing this one. One is my company and the second one is me as an owner of this particular report. So now we can see that we are called as admins. Admin is nothing but the owner of the complete report. So why we are admin? Because we are the one who have prepared everything from the scratch. So now, my dear viewers, a admin has the capability, and admin can go and make some another person as an admin. It is allowed. If I want to give the access of my workspace to my manager, I can also make him as an admin, or I can make her as an admin in my particular workspace so that he or she can go and access the complete information or the complete data in my workspace. So for that, what I have to do? Let us consider here, I'm going and typing my manager name. So whenever you are going to type your manager name, okay, you have to add people here. Now I'm typing my manager name. So whenever I am typing it, you can see that I have clicked on a particular name, and here we have an option that I should give the manager access as an admin or as a member or as a contributor or as a viewer. So now if I talk to you about the difference of all these things, so viewer can just view the report, admin is like an owner of the report, member can is a person who can interact with the report but cannot do any sort of changes, major changes, but contributor, they can remove or delete the data and they can do the changes, but member and contributor do not have the access to make another person as an admin. So now what I will do, I will go and click on admin here and I'll click on add. So when I am adding it, it is telling that it is added. Okay, now when I go back and see that I have created admin access, I have shared my workspace access to my manager as an admin. Now when they open the Power BI in their particular laptop or computers, and they can also see the workspace and what all the changes that I am doing and what all adding that I am doing in my particular report or in the workspace. Now in the same way, if I would like to give, I'm adding another person here. Let us consider I am adding another colleague of my particular team, and now I am giving this particular team member as just a viewer. Now what happens, this particular colleague to whom I am giving the access, he or she can just view the report. Okay, they can view the things that are there in the workspace. Okay, so this is how when they get into their Power BI, when they open Power BI, when they see that in the Power BI service, my workspace name, whatever it is there, that will be shown in their Power BI service, and when they click on it, they can view it. They can see the report, what data I have used, how visuals I have used, what kind of data I have input in the visuals. All these things I can view it in my workspace. So in my workspace, there will be a report, dashboard, an app, a semantic model. Everything will be there in my workspace. So everything they can view it. Now, when I have given the access as an admin to my manager, now he or she can go and completely do the changes. They can interact. They can do everything as an owner to that particular workspace. So this is how a workspace can be shared to your manager in Power BI. So my dear viewers, in this video, we have learned how to share the workspace access to the manager, and we have also learned how to see the access settings or how to give the access of different roles to the colleague and a manager in Power BI. Thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.